Helmets can only do their job if the helmet is adjusted properly. The strap is too loose, if the helmet's rocked back on the head, you're literally getting 50% of the benefit of wearing a helmet. The Canyon CFR helmet line consists of two models. We have a ventilated helmet aimed at high-performance road, gravel, and mountain bike racing. And we have the aerodynamic helmet that's also aimed at the same riders that want even more aerodynamic benefit. The first thing you're going to notice about the new Canyon CFR helmets is the HighBar system. It's something completely revolutionary when it comes to helmet retention. You can see we've done away with the traditional webbing straps that have a Y shape around the ear in favor of a very simple to use dial operated system that micro adjusts in the tighten and the loosen direction, making optimal fit simple and easy. We start by making sure that the HighBar system is fully open when you put the helmet on. You're gonna place the helmet on your head, so simply flip. You're gonna twist, tighten up under the chin, and you're ready to go. That's it, helmet fit made simple.
So I've been using this helmet for quite a few months now, and unfortunately I've had to test just about every single element. The style one is the first one you put it on. I've crashed with the helmet also, and I have to say it actually does fit perfectly. And stays that way to the point that I didn't know afterwards.
Simplifying the helmet adjustment process, we believe, will allow more riders to wear their helmet correctly. A helmet that's worn correctly is by definition a safer helmet.
You can loose it or tighten it with one hand, and that's great. During a race or during training, I feel safe all the time, and that's really important during a bike race.
The initial inspiration for HighBar had simply nothing to do with aerodynamics. What we learned along the way is that a molded system that doesn't flap in the wind is simply faster. And we can prove that the HighBar system at 50K an hour, for instance, is 7 watts faster. What does that mean? If you're an elite athlete going for a 50 kilometer breakaway and you're out there in the wind by yourself, 7 watts really matter. In the final sprint, where our elite athletes are putting out 1,500 watts, you know, an additional 20-watt benefit is pretty meaningful when it comes. That could be the difference between crossing the line first or centimeters behind in second place. What we tried to do with CFR-level helmets at Canyon is give the rider free speed. And we found that free speed just simply by changing from webbing straps to HighBar.
First time I used the helmet was right before Trucker and then in Trucker, and I won it. In the end, I was a lot alone, and everybody knows that aerodynamics is very important when you are riding alone, so it's good to have a helmet which performs well.
The straps may look rigid, but in fact, they're quite supple and soft and really adaptable to individual face shapes.
I just like the HighBar system that you don't like feel anything like touching you. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's like still touching at the bottom, but it's not like moving or something. You just put the helmet and it kind of like feels the same all the time. It feels fast, and I'm good. I'm happy. I could win directly the first race I did with it.
On most people's faces, the HighBar arms are going to sit a little bit off the face, and you're gonna feel this amazing airflow. So it's a new level of ventilation and cooling that you've just simply never had before with your old helmet system.
The HighBar system helps to letting the air flow through your face, but on the other hand, on top you have quite big holes, especially with the road helmet, which is super crucial.
Both these shapes were optimized with our partners at Swisside, who are experts in aerodynamic performance, but not only aerodynamic performance, thermodynamic performance, meaning cooling. You can't be fast if you're overheating. Thermal benefit is one of the main areas of research in world tour cycling these days, and our helmet line, you know, supports that philosophy with the balance of aerodynamic performance and thermodynamic performance. If we're gonna put CFR branding on our products, that means it's got to be fully endorsed and vetted by the world's best athletes. Something new like this Canyon HighBar equipped helmet is a really big change. So very early on in the process, we started engaging with our athletes, hearing their issues with current helmet straps and getting their input on how to optimize the system and make it work for a world tour rider as well as enthusiast riders around the world.
We did have some tweaks there on the high bar to make it actually a little bit wider. We know the sunglasses go underneath and it wasn't quite wide enough to fit for the wide model. And that added more comfort from my perspective and I think actually got used in the final model. So.
We've all felt it when you're descending down a fast hill going 50, 60 kilometers an hour and those webbing straps start flapping around. Well, it's creating turbulence and it's also creating noise. A high bar helmet is quieter, measurably. At various speeds, we've seen a 6 to 7.5 decibel benefit by riding a high bar helmet. What does that mean to you? If you're out on the road, it might be safer in that you can hear what's happening behind you. Quieter is better. Safety, of course, is the number one thing. We've got a rear panel that's reflective, so in low light conditions, when a headlight hits that, it's gonna light up and give you extra visibility. In addition to the reflective panel, we've got this really incredible light port. So we have a magnetic light that simply attaches to the rear. It's got several flashing functions, and it's super easy to charge with a USB-C cable. The system is proven to be faster in the wind tunnel. It's proven to be quieter. It's proven to be cooler. Add in micro adjustability and the ease of use makes it a win.